12 more aquariums. In today's video, we're going to talk about how we're going to filter all of these tanks, where we're going to put them, and what we're going to put in them. First, of course, I want to talk about the aquariums themselves. Hold Joey. I feel like you should ask to do that. These are your basic 15-gallon tanks. Made of glass, nothing fancy. I went with the cheapest option that was in stock. And I went through my fish store, one fish, two fish in Dartmouth, Nova Scotia, about an hour away from me, to order them in. These tanks are 24 inches long. They're only 12 inches wide and 12 inches tall. A really interesting sized aquarium that likely was one of close to the first aquarium you ever got, and or you probably have one or have had one, you know, at some point. I know myself, I've always wanted to do a proper breeding setup system, and we have in the past. I've done it with 30-gallon tanks and 10-gallon tanks and all different types and sizes, but focused on discus. What I'm going to do with these is incredibly interesting, but I'll be honest, I'm bouncing these ideas off of you guys right now. Boy, that light's pretty bright, isn't it? Let's talk about filtration first. When filtering 12 aquariums and or setting up a breeding aquarium system, you want them to be economically possible. You don't need it fancy. In fact, I'm probably not going to have substrate in most of these. It's going to be relatively affordable to do this. Especially if you guys get these for that dollar a gallon sale you get in the States. We don't have that here. I got to pay sticker price, but it is what it is. My main concern, of course, is how I'm going to filter 12 tanks and not go broke doing it. Now, being that these are 2 feet long, there's six of them. I guess I could do six in each row, but that would be like 12 feet long. I don't want that. I got to have it more compact. If I put them side by side, I could have six up top and six below. We're going to talk about where we're going to put these here in a moment. So knowing that you're going to look at it from this angle, you will be seeing it from here. You won't be able to see through the sides. It doesn't matter. I might even black the sides out and the back and only be able to see through the front so all the fish don't interact with each other and or get stressed out, because I might have something breeding in this tank that doesn't do well besides this fish, or vice versa, and or maybe we do just set these up as little scape nano tanks, but we'll get to that here in a minute. Filtration. Well, I'm gonna direct your attention over here to a guy that makes videos on YouTube. I think this video was made 8 years ago, July 13th, 2014. How to easy do-it-yourself aquarium filter, the Hamburg Matten filter. I used to use these a lot, and essentially you take a sponge like this. You put it in the tank. This one's not the sponge I'm going to use. This is an example. I think this is only 3/4 inch. Also, Luke got at it, so it's not a great example. And it's used, and it's like flimsy. I'm gonna be using 2-inch thick, 30 PPI foam. PPI stands for pores per inch. I'm going to take it, I'm gonna put it right there. So when you're looking in the tank, that's all you see. The fish can't get behind it. Maintenance is this, take it out, which you really rarely do, if ever. It acts as your mechanical as well as your biological filter. You rinse it in tank water, put it back in. Behind it, we're gonna run it with an air pump with a simple PVC contraption on probably a piece of tile of some sort, and I'll build it 12 times over. It's not a big deal. I'm gonna build some lids, very easy. I mean, to light the tanks up, maybe if I am lighting them, probably some sort of a shop light. I'm going economical. I don't need anything crazy or fancy. But the benefit to these guys here is simple. We have a massive amount of biological filtration as well as mechanical filtration built into the whole thing. It's also visually pleasing. You don't see heaters, you don't see inputs or outputs, you see nothing. You just see this foam, which is absolutely probably one of the best ways to breed fish. Now, remember when we went to the fish stores? They would separate their tanks with a Hamburg Matten filter. And you could have something on one side and something on the other. Maybe that's something I look to in the future, where I want to get into doing different things, and or it could be an interesting way to introduce new fish to each other. They can kind of you know, sense the other fish on the other side. Perhaps they can even sense the hormones they're putting off, etc., and maybe release it eventually. I think that that's not that great of an idea. I think visuals are very important to fish as well. So we'll kind of scrap that idea and kind of go back to here. But I thought it was absolutely fascinating that some stores were doing that when I was in Ohio, that they were separating it with a sponge and the tank became two. I love that idea. So that is what we're going to do for filtration. I'm not doing anything crazy or anything fancy. I'm going to get some sponge off Amazon or my local fish store, 2 inches thick. It's going to sit in there. I don't have to silicone it or anything. I'm going to take it. I'm going to place it in there. I'm going to take some PVC pipe attached with some airline hose, and it's going to run the tank. You guys will see exactly how it works. The total system might take up, oh, I don't know, maybe 120 watts of power. So each tank is only using about 10 watts of continuous power, which is fantastic. But where are we going to place them? Obviously, there's nowhere in the gallery that I can have these small tanks side by side, which would equate to being 12 feet long because there are 12 of them. So the other option is the electrical room and or the quarantine area, which I'm kind of starting to go against it because with 35 tanks out here, we're going to have so many new fish. I'm going to need quarantine. I'm not going against my core values of just getting fish and crossing your fingers because you never have problems with a new fish. I need to quarantine. So I'm up in the air with how I'm going to quarantine. I've got other places in my house to quarantine fish, but I gotta stop doing that. So I could take a bunch of them and put all 12 side by side like this. Boom, 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 boom. And put it over here. On the wall that the 9 acrylic tanks are being built for and put here. Obviously, I'm going to have the acrylic tanks here. This stand, all these tanks are standing 6 feet tall. It's going to leave me with about 16 to 18 inches of absolute clear space under it. But I'm, and I would line them up 12 feet side by side, all 12 tanks coming out this far. So that means that the tanks are only taking up 18 inches of space and then the tops of the tank are coming out more. So I don't think I'm going to need a tremendous amount of clearance because I'm going to give you a visual example here in a moment. But I can have them all coming out this way underneath the 9 tank system, which doesn't leave me any room for the sumps that I'm building for there. So I got to toss, well, this is why I kind of make videos with you guys, because I kind of want to see what you guys think. Obviously, by the time you see this video, though, I will have probably have come to a conclusion. And because a lot of you have been watching me for a long period of time, I have a strong feeling we're all going to come to this to the same conclusion anyways. However, this piece of cell cast acrylic, 10 millimeters thick, just shy of half inch thick, 12 millimeter would be half inch, is 16 by 16. It's essentially the length and width. It's essentially the width of the tanks that are going in there. This is how much space it would take. And of course, that's butted right up against the wall, but these won't be because they're going to be bulkheads behind it, and I'm going to need a clearance of at least 2 inches. Leaving me with probably about 6 inches there, 4 inches, to get my hands in. So I guess I don't need a ton of clearance above them. And then these are on the floor a few inches out, so you got to watch when you got your ladders and whatnot. And then that means I don't know where I'd put the sumps. Maybe I could put them beside it. Maybe I could build like a little rack. Ooh, that's a fun idea. This wall here can hold about 15 feet of tanks. The rack will be about 13 feet long, leaving me with 2 feet before it gets to this stand. Maybe I build sumps on a little rack by themselves, so the top level flows into one and the bottom level flows into the other if I go with one of the ideas that I have. Oh, I'm ruining things that I'm thinking about doing, but I'm thinking about making the top rack of the new tanks all fresh and the bottom rack of all the new tanks all salt. Imagine that. A cube salt tank, a couple of 4 foot long salt tanks, a 3 foot salt. I think that's a fun, interesting thing to do. And that's what I'm doing right now, is I'm trying to create something that doesn't exist. And that's like the whole reason I got into do-it-yourself, is because a lot of the times I do it because I can't afford it, or it's not available, it doesn't exist, it's hard to get a hold of, or I need something specific. So I have to create it. And we have to create a working system. Downside is if I put these guys on the floor, water changers are gonna be a nightmare. Water changes a lot of times work off gravity, but of course I could also just do some sort of a pump system where I drop a pump with a hose in it, pump some water out, that sort of thing. I mean, everything has an alternative thing we could actually do to it. By the time you guys see this video, though, I think I will have a final idea of what I'll be doing. What are we going to put in these, guys? That's what you want to hear. Well, with 12 individual aquariums, it's an interesting conversation to have. They are all standalone systems. It doesn't matter if this gets along with this or if this is fresh and this is salt. It doesn't matter because they're not tied in. They're all going to be on their own individual, like little ecosystems, their own filtration. I've wanted to for a long time, and this is a self-confession, is to get into fancy plecos. And I never did it due to moral reasons. I thought that I would be treating fish and live animals like trading cards, like I'm collecting them. Because that's essentially what I would be doing, because I want to collect a lot of like of the rarer type of plecos and plecos that I've never had. Like, for example, the zebra pleco. I find those guys are, well, obviously one of the pinnacles of the rare and, well, expensive plecos. But what if we had 12 different species? That could be interesting. I thought then maybe if I do it on a rack where they're above and below, I could breed on the top and do my little collection on the bottom. Or I breed in all of them. But what would I breed? To be fair, I kind of want to get back into shrimp. And I'm talking the very basics of cherry shrimp. I'm fascinated by shrimp. I have freshwater shrimp, saltwater shrimp. I love all types of shrimp. And that's where I got to leave this video in your guys' hands, is ask, what would you do if you had these 12 aquariums? The filtration is not up for discussion. That's what I'm doing. Because remember, I got to pay the power bill and I got to pay to set these up. But do you like the idea of them being on the ground, all lined up? Or is that something we can't even really appreciate? I guess the camera doesn't know if it's on the floor, if it's standing up. But or do we put it in that back room where it's more isolated? Or do we figure out a way to have maybe 6 on the ground side by side, which is the 12 feet, there's an idea, on the ground, and that's where we do our little fancy collection, and then we have 6 in the utility room for breeding purposes, and or I guess quarantine. What do we do with these 12 tanks? What would you do? What do you want me to do? Let me know in the comment section below. I thoroughly look forward to reading them, and to be fair, I think I'm going to wait till this video comes out before I make a final decision. So please participate in the comment section below. I've said it for many, many years. I believe the comments are the second half of the video, and you know what I'm talking about, because when you're watching a funny TikTok, you look at the comments even when the video is still playing, because that's like half of the involvement. Like, and it's still the same on you. I do the same thing. Anyways, I'm excited. This is fun for me. Yeah. And I think you guys are going to love it too. Anyways, I've really got to get back to work. There's a ton of things I got to do. Unfortunately, all I could do is take the cardboard off of these and store them underneath the 700 for now. I just cleared all that out and kind of put them off to the side. They came a little too soon for what I'm ready for, but we got them now. Now I got to order in the foam. I got to get the air pumps. I got to get some PVC. I got to get some connections, et cetera, et cetera. That's plenty of time to hear your opinion. Let me know in the comment section below. See you soon.